Morning, or afternoon, or evening. I'm Naomi, and you're watching part 2 of my reading vlog. Part 1 will be linked somewhere up here. I'm not sure if this is mirrored or not, but you'll see it pop up on the screen. To start this vlog off, today I have a resting day. The few days has been very hectic and tiring and exhausting, so today I've planned to just relax. So I've got two things on the planning. One, edit my part 1 vlog, and two, read. Because I genuinely do want to read and feel like reading. So that's what I'm gonna do. So I'm gonna start my day and hope you enjoy this part 2 of my vlog. I just wanted to pop in to say that I just read 162 pages today. Booyah! Oh, I'm so happy. I haven't been able to read more than 100 pages these couple of 4 or 5 days. And finally, I've been reading today and I've gone somewhere. But, I mean, the ending is coming closer and closer. And with each page I turn, I'm like, no! I don't want to, but I do want to, like, I don't want it to end. I do want to continue this story and forever, ever be in this book and this series. But there is an end coming and I'm dreading it so much. But I'm having a lot of fun. It's such a good read and I don't want to rush myself through it and that it all becomes one big blur of a story. I really want to experience everything. So yeah, I basically just wanted to celebrate the fact that I read more than 100 pages today. And I'm very glad. Overall, today's just been a good day. I have a good feeling about today. But I have work tomorrow. So I'm not sure if I'll be able to read and if I'll have enough energy to read. But beside that, I also need to go to sleep now because I have to work tomorrow. So that was just it. Thank you for listening. Good morning. It's Sunday. Yes. Weekend. So yesterday, I didn't read at all. Not a single page. It's partly because I was very, very tired and just wasn't in the right mindset to read. Also, because I don't want this book to finish. I don't want this series to end. I could just cry with how much I love this series and to think that it's about to end. It's heartbreaking and I'm so anxious of what Alwyn is going to do with the characters. I honestly don't know, but I could just cry right now thinking of whatever she can do with them. Today I am planning to read some, maybe even finish it. I only have 150 pages to go. With the pace I'm going through this book, I could finish this within 2 hours or 3 hours the most. So plan of today is 1. Work on school a bit. 2. Finish editing and posting my part 1 vlog. And 3. Read. Try to read. I'm gonna do it. I'm gonna finish Hero at the Fall tonight. I'm gonna do it. I have exactly 74 pages left to go. I'm gonna finish Hero at the Fall. I'm already extremely emotional. It's like a matter of time before I start crying. I already told my mom, if you hear someone ugly cry, it's me. It's because of the book. So now there's no way back. I'm gonna finish Hero at the Fall. I'm gonna finish Hero at the Fall. I finished Hero at the Fall by Alwyn Hamilton. I've cried a lot in these past 1.5 hours. My eyes are going to be so swollen in the morning. Oh my god. This book. This series. Like, At first, I cried because of solid reasons. Some messed up stuff happens in the ending. But, like, the final 20 pages, I just solidly cried because it was ending. There was no real reason to cry other than that it was ending. And I feel like Alwyn really wrapped it up so nicely. Like, I've never seen it done like this in YA finale before, and I wish everyone would do it like this because it's so satisfying. It was so good. And like, this book, this final book, just made me realize what this series, what this trilogy stands for. It's honestly a contribution to storytelling. That's the theme of this book, like storytelling, the power of storytelling, the magic of storytelling, the importance of storytelling. It's just one big contribution to storytelling, and it's the most amazing thing to read in book form. I'm just gonna go to bed now and think about this beauty. Final words will be, read The Rebel of the Sands trilogy by Alwyn Hamilton. Read it now. We're certain with desire, the pleasures, pain and fire burn. So come on. Today I read a total of 2 pages. I started with extremely loud and incredibly close, as I need to read that for college. And I actually was supposed to be halfway through today, but I really do want to read it because my classmates are very enthusiastic about it, and I think it's a fun read. It's an okay read. So I do want to read it, but today I didn't get any further than 2 pages. I have been reading fanfiction, but I don't think you're supposed to count that along with the readathon. I'm also still a little bit overwhelmed with finishing Hero at the Fall last night. And yeah, fanfiction is just light and bubbly and easy to read. I kind of clung onto that. And I just wanted to say that the upcoming 2 days, today too, but I have a very unexpected busy schedule, and it's probable that I will have none or little updates. Wednesday is a little bit less hectic, so maybe I can get some reading in on Wednesday, but I'm not sure if I'll have the energy to. But I have made a deal with myself. Well, not really a deal, I'm just forcing myself to finish 2 books by the end of this week. Extremely Loud and Incredibly Close will be the first one, because I want to read it before the final group discussion. I'm planning on reading The Wrath and the Dawn by Renée, Ahdieh, as it is, in my eyes, a very easy read. Like, not too heavy. And I think I'll fly through it, and I love 1001 Nights retelling, so yeah. That's my plan, but I probably won't start it till Wednesday, so don't expect me to read these upcoming 1.5 days. But I will, I must finish 2 books before the end of this week. I will. That being said, I'm gonna crawl in my bed, get as much sleep as possible, and read some more of the fanfiction I'm reading, because it's so good. Talk to you guys later. For me, it's been a while since I vlogged, so it feels like ages since I've talked to you, but for you it's just a matter of second. But hi, it's Thursday. Last time we spoke was Monday. I indeed didn't read anything the past couple of 2 days. I was so busy and couldn't find the energy to pick up a book. I did finish the fanfic, and I'm very glad because I'm finally released from its grip. No, but it was a great fic. It was a fic I hadn't read yet, so it was much fun. Plan of today, I'm gonna puzzle, listen to the audiobook of Extremely Loud and Incredibly Close by Jonathan Safran Foer, currently on page 6 and due to these kind of pages. It's very hard for me to get through. So I hope the audiobook will help me more, because I genuinely do want to read this book. It seems very interesting and fun. So that's the plan for today. The audiobook is 4 hours. I don't think I'll finish 4 hours of listening today, because I woke up a little bit later than expected. And if I go listen for 4 hours to an audiobook, my whole afternoon is gone. So maybe I'll split it up and do 2 hours today and 2 hours tomorrow. As I mentioned in, I think, part one of this vlog, I'm not gonna count the pages I read. In part one of my vlog, I said I wouldn't count along the audiobook or ebook pages, but obviously I have the book with this, and because there are pictures and other stuff, I'm going to keep the book with me and read along. So I will count these with the total pages read, or pages read today count. And I also hopefully get some reading in from The Wrath and the Dawn by Renée Ahdieh. I really love this spine. I love gold foil. Love it. So that's kind of the plan of today, and I just wanted to update you on that. I hope I can get some footage of the puzzle in, because I'd love to show you what puzzle I'm making. So this is the puzzle I'm planning to make. It's obviously Disney. I love Disney puzzles. I only do Disney puzzles. And it's 1500 puzzle pieces. I've made this one twice already, but it's still just so much fun to make. Just look at them. Oh, I love it. So yeah, this was going to keep me occupied for a couple of hours at least. So yesterday I read a total of 12 pages. And I felt like I needed to officially announce that failure. I could have predicted it. Like, I had 3 busy days. I always need a detox day. So yeah, nothing productive happened yesterday. I did puzzle, but I had a sing-along party instead of listening to the audiobook. I hope I don't fall into the same temptation today, because I have to finish that book before Monday. That was kind of what I popped in to say. I'm a failure, and let's hope today is gonna be better. Came back from work and I look overheated because I am. I wanted to talk about yesterday, because yesterday I finished one book. Actually, I finished 2 books. So let's talk about that. The first book was, as predicted, extremely loud and incredibly close. I gave it 4 out of 5 stars. The audiobook was phenomenal. I enjoyed it. I laughed about the narration, and it was a really great audiobook. Though, like, the book has pictures, other graphics, which obviously don't show in the audiobook, and I noticed, because I was holding the book alongside me, that they also skipped parts and due to the lack of the pictures in the audiobook. But overall, it was great. It's a book with meaning and emotions, and I enjoyed reading it for my literature class. In the second book, this is a fun story, because I haven't been reading the past couple of days, because I've been reading fanfiction. After finishing the first fanfiction, I was like, I need to reread this fanfiction. So I did. And I finished that one yesterday, and then suddenly I was like, but this is actually a published book. They changed the names and everything, but still, it's that story. So I practically read an ebook of an actual book. Win, win for me. I'm gonna count that one along as an actual book, because it's published. Why shouldn't I? I've been reading, and that's what readathons are about. So I won't add the first fanfiction I read, I'll add the second one, because that's actually a published book. Suddenly, I finished 6 books, and as promised, I finished 2 books before Sunday. Though I was planning on reading The Wrath and the Dawn before Sunday, or finish it on Sunday. I'm like 45 pages in The Wrath and the Dawn right now, and I'm pretty confused of what it's about and who is who, but still, like, I'm flying through it and I'm actually excited to keep reading it. I'm very tired from work, so I don't think I'll pick up a book this evening, but who knows, I'd even be able to finish it by the end of tomorrow, but I also have a lot of school work to do, so I'm not sure if I'll be able to achieve that. And I'm still kind of longing to read fanfiction because it's just so much fun and so easy to read, but oh, I shouldn't read fanfiction. So that's kind of an update. I'm gonna go have dinner now and slowly die. Alright, so plan of the evening is I have some articles on homework which I need to read and need to find sound arguments and statements and opinions, etc., etc., on my thoughts on homework for tomorrow. I still haven't done it yet, even though it's past 9 p.m. and I still have to do the work I was supposed to do this afternoon, so yay, but hopefully I'll finish that pretty quickly. Thankfully there aren't this many articles, so I can get through it very easily, and then hopefully get some reading done of The Wrath and the Dawn. Yeah, haven't read yet today, and I'm actually on page 40, not 45 as I said yesterday. Anyway, I hope to get some reading done because I actually do really want to read this, so I'm gonna pop on some music, make my homework, and read. Good night.
So, I haven't been doing well this second half of the readathon. And now, you guys are all like, honey, we've been new. I know, but I came up with a game plan. Alright, yeah. Listen on, this is good. Yesterday, I started reading a new fanfiction again. I know, but it's my favorite, so anyway, it's actually one of my favorites. I don't think it's my absolute favorite, but the game plan is one chapter of the fanfiction equals two chapters of The Wrath and the Dawn. I haven't been this smart in quite a while, and that really says something about my intelligence, but all right. So I mean, right now I'm in chapter 2, and in a few minutes I'm gonna relax on my bed. I've got some crisps, got water, gonna cuddle into my pillows, finish reading chapter 2 of the fanfic, and then gonna read 4 chapters of The Wrath and the Dawn. And The Wrath and the Dawn doesn't have very long chapters. They're overall pretty short. And the chapters of a fanfiction are also not too long. I don't know. They're not very long, but long enough. I think I'd spend 20 minutes per chapter. And maybe 10 minutes per chapter of The Wrath and the Dawn. I don't know. But it feels like an equal deal. And I feel so smart. Today it's 26th of March and the readathon is coming to an end in just a few days. Like, it's Monday today and on Saturday it's the final day, and I am determined to finish 2 more books. So I need to get through The Wrath and Dawn ASAP. And I think that if I have enough self-control, I can pull this off. That's what I'm going to do. I'm gonna enjoy my evening. Talk to you soon. Guys, guys, guys! The plan's working! The plan is actually working! Alright, so last night and this morning, I read a total of 7 fanfiction chapters. You can do the math. I was supposed to read 14 chapters this day. I had to read 14 chapters and I counted them and it was more than 150 pages. Do you know what did I do the whole afternoon? I read The Wrath and the Dawn, and now I'm even past the 14 chapters. I'm past just 150 pages. I've almost finished the book. Like, I only have like 30 pages left to go. Girl!
plan for this evening is I'm gonna go shower, then get into bed and finish those 30 pages of The Wrath and the Dawn and finish my 7th book, and that means that I have 4 full days left to finish one more book to reach my goal of reading 8 books this readathon. That's so exciting, even though I completely ignored school today. Like, I had my day off. I did not skip any classes, but I had to do some homework and I didn't. But regret is for later, so I'm extremely excited. Like, I've almost finished within a dawn. I'm not sure yet what book I'm going to read next. I still have to think that over. But tomorrow is Wednesday and I have school till noon. And then I'm gonna go, it depends on the weather really, but I'm planning to go into the center of Amsterdam and do some shopping. And I'm planning to pop in Lush and buy some bath bombs, because we don't have a bath in this house, but we're going on a little vacation in a few days and there's a bath. I'm gonna go wild and buy me some bath bombs. On my way there, I will pass 2 bookstores, so I'll probably visit those 2, see what they have to offer. And hopefully I'll get some footage of that. That's a little bit explanation of what you're hopefully about to see of tomorrow. I'm gonna go shower, finish the book, and then shamelessly read the fanfiction. A sad announcement to make. My fairy lights died yesterday. I immediately ordered new ones, but still. But in other news, I got myself some Lush. And as I said, I needed some bath bombs. And I bought 2. One of them is the Metamorphosis bath bomb. It's like a black one with black pepper and something. I have no idea what it is. And the other one, okay, bye. The other one I bought was Think Pink. I'm not gonna get them out of the packages. I want to keep them safe. But Think Pink is a pink bath bomb with glitters. And it smells like sweet vanilla and another thing. I have no idea what it is. It's got glitters, so. So yeah, Amsterdam, I went to Lush, and no, wait, I got lost, then went to Lush. I popped in some stores, some clothing stores, some shoe stores, but I didn't buy anything because money. And I went to Waterstones in Amsterdam, but honestly, I hate bookstores. Okay, no, let me rephrase. I enjoy bookstores, but looking at the offer they have and price range, I do not like bookstores. Overpriced, can get it cheaper on the internet, and they mostly only have paperbacks when I want hardcovers. Like, you know, if I want to buy a book in a bookstore, like pay that much money, most of the times for a book I really really want, and most books I really really want, I want in hardcover. So and then I walked past the American bookstore in Amsterdam. I was like, I could go in, but that'd be just a waste of time. And in other news, I finished The Wrath and the Dawn by Renée, Ahdieh yesterday. Let's just jump straight into it. I gave it 3 out of 5 out of 5 stars. I really, like,
It's an enjoyable read. It's a very entertaining read. Quality-wise, it's not the best. It lacks a bit of world-building and character-building, and I mean, the glossary at the back really helped, but some things just felt a bit sloppy and out of place. I immediately ordered The Rose and the Dagger, the second installment of the duology. And it was supposed to arrive today, so I didn't bring any book with me while I traveled. And I thought I would jump into The Rose and the Dagger today, but it got delayed, and now it's supposedly coming in tomorrow, but I don't really trust them anymore. I do know that I won't be reading today. One, because I don't like reading in my bedroom light. It's not bright enough to read on my bed. And I really want to be in my bed right now. And I'm really tired, and tomorrow I have to get up insanely early. Like, my alarm is at 5:30. And I'm not really used to that, so I'm gonna go to sleep very early tonight. And see, my cheeks are so red of exhaustion. So yeah, unfortunately, no reading today. I'm glad I finished my 7th book yesterday, and I hope that in the upcoming final 3 days of the readathon, I'll be able to finish another book. Now I'm just going to sniff more of my bath bombs and dream of the baths I'm going to have in a couple of weeks. And then I'm gonna crawl on my bed, cry over the loss of my fairy lights, and sleep. Alright, this is me, like, 5 minutes later after the last clip, and I'm gonna finish this book. I've been reading Summer Days and Summer Nights ever since, I think, summer 2015. It's about time I finish this. I have literally like a little more over 100 pages to go. I've got 4 of the 12 short stories left to read. If I read just one story of 30 pages each day, I can make it. I can make it. I can finish 8 books. I'm going to read this book and will be finally removed from my Goodreads currently reading.
Hi. My new fairy lights came in the mail today. I'm really happy with them. And another thing came in the mail today. The Rose and the Dagger by Renée Ahdieh. I'm not gonna start it now because it's 400 pages and there's no way I can read 400 pages in 2 days. But still, I wanted to show it to you. I've realized some reason... holding this camera is not working out for me. Alright. Sorry if the sounds were muffled at some point. I probably had my hand on the microphone. I don't even know. But this book, we have to talk about the colors. Because blue with this weird red. I'm just sad that the naked book isn't blue. And I just noticed there's this weird stain. I don't know what it is, but I don't feel like returning it or making a new order, so I'm just letting it be. I don't know what it is. Anyway, we've got the book. It looks pretty. And now I can finish the series whenever I want. Other than that, I'll finish Summer Days, Summer Nights tomorrow. I'm not gonna pick it up now. I'm too tired. Energy level is too low, not the reading mood I'm aiming for. So this was basically me just saying hi, showing my new fairy lights and my new book. Oh, bye! So the new fairy lights glow in the bloody dark. Like small dark in the sky. I'm me, I wanna try. Take a so come bite. Strike the match, now we're a perfect match. Perfect somehow, we were meant for one another. Come a little closer. Flame again for me. Fire me gasoline. Hello, so today is a very special day. It is the one to last day of the Emoji-a-thon, Readathon. And because
tomorrow, the official final day of the Emojiathon, I have got to work the whole day, and then I'm gonna go out partying with co-workers of mine because one of them is leaving, so we gotta celebrate that. So that means I won't read tomorrow, I won't be able to film tomorrow, and therefore I wanted to close it off today, right now, as we speak. So yeah, like 30 days of vlogging, and well, it wasn't every day vlogging, and neither did I read every day, but 30 days. It's gonna feel weird not thinking about when to film, what to film, to think ahead of the clips I'm going to make and stuff. It will be nice not to have my mind on vlogging for a while now. As for the readathon and like reading a whole month, I think definitely a readathon that runs through a whole month is less effective for me than a readathon that lasts not longer than a week or so. Like with a month long, it really does put any pressure on me. I don't feel like there's a deadline. I don't feel like I have to read to, you know, make a successful readathon. So in that way, I don't think I'll do a full month of readathon anymore. But nevertheless, I really enjoyed making this reading vlog. I'm almost finished with Summer Day, Summer Nights, and I will pop in when that's finished so I can officially announce the amount of pages and books I've read this month. But overall, it's been a great month and I love showing. I love bringing you around in my month of doing loads of weird things. Like this month was very weird for me. Yeah, I went through some things and it's been a roller coaster. It's been a roller coaster and I still enjoyed it so much. And reading, I read some great books this month. One of my favorites. It's been a good month. I'll probably take a rest from reading after this whole month of reading. Probably gonna fall back into watching loads of movies and series. I always tend to do that. Like I read a lot and then I just need a break and just watch movies and TV shows. And I think that's gonna happen for the month of April, but who knows, because I've got some really great books waiting for me, like Conjuring of Light and The Rose and the Dagger, Walk on Earth a Stranger. They're all waiting and begging for me to read them. So, but we'll see. At least for April, I'm not gonna force myself to do anything, because at one point it did feel kind of forced for me to read, as I kind of got out of it along the way. And yeah, that was kind of what I wanted to talk about, and I wanted to properly close this off. You will see my face again as I have finished Summer Day, Summer Nights. I'll see you in the next clip. It's finished. I have to talk very quietly. Everyone is already in bed. Finished Summer Days and Summer Nights. Overall, I gave it 4 out of 5 stars. I'll leave my Goodreads link down below. And for all the books I've read in this month, I'm going to have a March wrap up, and I will get more into thoughts and opinions in that video. So it will come your way very soon. So in the complete month of March, I have read 3,145 pages. I have finished 8 books, or 7.5, or whatever. 8 books. I finished 8 books. I'm so happy. Like when I finished 8 books in January, I was already like, girl, how did you even do that? And now I managed to do it again. But yeah, that's it. I really want to thank you for watching, especially if you made it all the way to the end of the vlog. Like, well done, kudos to you. Now, like, comment, subscribe, share, you know the drill. Let's not get into that. And I just wish you a happy day, or a happy tomorrow, or just a happy week. And I hope to see you soon. Bye.